What's happening, lads? We're gonna have part two here of our Irish stereotype mini series thingy we're trying. We got a lot of good feedback on the last one, so I said, fuck it, I'll do another one. The gameplay you can see is Keith 90 profiles rogue or whatever profile he was using. I'm actually losing track. I think I have about 70 profiles belonging to him on my friends list alone. So if anyone has tried to add me, you can blame him. The reason it's kind of a long, it's a Moab gameplay. The reason it's kind of long is just he was sniping at the start, but then a lot of Modern Warfare 3 shit happened and he just said fuck it, he's gonna go out of his way to get the Moab, and that's what he did. So first off the bat, you know I mentioned Cavan and Leitrim, and if anyone from Cavan or Leitrim has internet at all, or has plugged it into a diesel kind of forklift or whatever they think they're using, I'm gonna speak slowly and say I'm so sorry for taking the mick out of your dirt counties, and hopefully I'll get no more death threats written in crayon, because I got a couple of them there over the weekend. what I'm going to be talking about this one is kind of, I was touching on a lot of things last time, as I said, I ran out of time, but this one I'm going to be going through the different, what different countries think of Ireland in general. Well, Americans will buy anything from us. If I spit on a pair of old jocks and say Brian Brew left him in a house party abroad in fucking Cool Cullen's Gaff, they will buy it. I get at least 60 euro off them. And that's just a fact. I'm not too proud to say it, but I am fucking proud to say it. No, they're ticking off. I actually went down to a small area down Loch Derg, down where I live, and there was a load of these smooth rocks down by the water. Like, I was just sitting around. I seen a kind of bus of Americans pull up, and I swear to God, I walked up to a big group of them and told them that there were rocks taken from a burial site at the other end of the lake. And they must have come out there about 40, 60 pounds. Like, I mean, oh, it was brilliant. And that's ticked. Like, they love the idea that we are actually fresh-faced, freckly midgets hanging around pots of gold waiting for someone to come along and shank you. I mean, the end of the rainbow is not a pretty place, if you think about it. I mean, if you go to the end of the rainbow, you're going to end up in Ballymun. And that's just it. And you're going to get your fucking trolley robbed on you, whatever you're doing. And that's the Americans that think of us. That's just them. I mean, there's a lot more people that think worse things than us, so we get a good time off the Americans. But English people, I mean, I'm trying not to sound hateful at all, right? But like being on PSN, you get a lot of people, like you meet a lot of people, but once you hear that, all right, mates, nah, it's gonna ship you, you ain't got nothing. I mean, that, and then you're automatically gonna go, right, if I open my mouth here, I'm getting potatoed. And you open your mouth, you say something to your friend, you might be even talking to them, and that's it. You fucking parkies, are you hanging around as this in your caravans? Hanging around chippy, waiting to eat the scraps out of the skips, you dirty gypsies. And like, there's nothing we can do to say, I don't. Because that's adding fuel to the fire. Of course you fucking do, you Irish bastard. All you do, hanging around Tarmac Academy with people's driveways. You did a bang up job, mate. Me mum loves it. And that is just, oh, it gets to my tits because none of it's original. I mean, I have, don't know how many times I've been told I live on a site where I get my internet from fucking Supermax, and all my relatives have a 9 fingers like on their face. And like, I don't care about being slagged. Being slagged is grand, because like I slag everyone all the time. At any opportunity, I will slag anyone. But like, when it's not funny and it's not original, it kind of gets on your tits a bit more. You kind of get more aggravated, and that's because like, you're like, it's not funny. I mean, I slag people for fun. Every time any English person comes up, I just think of this thing in The Simpsons where Ringo Starr is talking to Marge. Simpsons is great for stereotyping. Dear Marge, thank you for that lovely picture. I hung it on me wall. Yes, we do have French fries over here in England. We just call them chips, and that's all I can say really. And that just gets me, like, that gets me through the day, basically. Kind of slagging English people like that is just brilliant. And I just, you talk about Norwich, like, their farmers over there are creepy. I mean, is that, are you stood down there, is it good fields? See my sheep? I said, oi, come out here, Desi. I want you to fucking come down here and do my lawns. He's like, nah, I'll go for a cupper. Down the old pad. Okay, grand. Lovely. And that's all I can do. And like, it's not funny, it's not original, but I mean, that's not what you're gonna get. And Scottish people are brilliant. I love Scottish people get so angry. Like, you can, if I can, I can put on an okay Scottish accent, and if you can convince them you're Scottish, because you know they'd be a bit slow from the drinking and then the heroin. But yeah, Scottish people get, you fucking bastard, you ever fucking tear you from Scotland again, I'll fucking slit your fucking throat. And they get really fucky and they get really offended by it. But like, and then they can't say anything to Irish people because we're basically cut from the same fucking cloth, like, you know what I mean? Apart from, again, the alcoholism and the sheep rape. But these stereotypes are universal. But for Irish people, it's different because it's not universal, but they think we're the pikeys, or they think we're farmers, or they think we're, you know, famine dodgers. Basically, I know you use the word famine dodgers a lot because all they come up is the famine and how we all died during the famine. And as I know, I didn't touch on too many things there, and that's kind of what I want to do. I wanted you to leave me comments and tell me what you want to hear, what kind of stereotypes you want to hear, or do you want me to continue the series. But I love you, and I'll talk to you again.